then I will send it to you. Okay. So, once again, good morning, my dear friends. And today we are going into the first chapter of social science. I am sure all of you got the, yesterday, did you all watch the that video I sent in the group? But I sent it very late at after 10 o'clock. Yeah. How many of you watched that video? Please give me a thumbs up if you watched the video. If you are not watched the video, give me a thumbs down. If you watched the video, please give me a thumbs up. If you are not watched, okay, thumbs down. No issue. Okay, Asma has watched. Okay, so I see only Asma has watched the video. Rest of you not watched the video. Okay, no problem. But after the class, once again, if you watch the video, you get a clarification of what is the. This is all about sources. Okay, now I'm going to give an exercise for you. All of you are going to do. So, I want you to find out your childhood memories. Okay? Your childhood memories. At the age of one, what you are doing. At the age of two or the three. Or any proof. Give me a proof of what you were doing in your childhood. You can get your photos, any childhood photos or anything else. Or you can ask your parents. I give you 1 minute for this exercise to do. All of you, please get up and get me a proof of what you were doing in the childhood.
Sir, I have childhood photo.
Okay, come on. All of you, go and get the childhood photos.
I also have it.
Yeah, go get it, get it, get it. I give 1 minute for everyone to do it.
Sir,
if you have it, if you those who don't have it, you have another option. Those who have it, please get that photos. And those who don't have, you have another exercise. What is? I want you to find out your great grandfather. That means your father's grandfather or your mother's grandfather's name. That you have to find out and you get their photos. If their photo is available, you get that.
Which photo, sir?
Your grandfather's, great grandfather's photo. Your sir, father's, you... your father's father, father's grandfather's photo.
Sir, I am sent out.
What, Umesh? You are sent?
Sir, I have pictures, sir. Like okay, childhood
okay. Pictures. Okay, you can send it to me. You sir, can send it to me. See, send it to me in personal WhatsApp message.
Sir, you need to give you a show of my father's grandfather's photo.
Okay. Okay, you are so nice. So, okay, we all will have fun. Now, what will I do? I'll stop share the screen. Okay, come all of you show your photos or childhood photos, your great grandparents' photos or grandpa or grandma's photos. Just show me on the video. Come on. For just you just show to all of us. Come on, let me see. Hasna?
I sent in WhatsApp.
Okay. Hasna has sent me. I will share it once again. Okay. Wait a minute. What about others? Please show me.
Haliya. Sir, I send you after some time because
okay.
My photo have been covered.
Okay, if you cannot show it in the video, please send it to me a personal message. But if you can show in your video, please do that.
Yes, sir. My photo.
Ah, shy photo. Oh my gosh, shy, so cute, so small boy. Great. I will also show the photo. This is a photo of Husna. Okay, Husna's photos, Husna's child photos.
Sir, not seeing anything.
Give you in picture, sir.
Yeah. You can see this. Okay.
Now you can see the screen.
Okay. Alia's, because that will take a lot of time. That's the reason I don't want to do. This is Alia's great grandfather's photo.
Sir, you can share the screen.
You all sent me. If you all sent me, I will definitely share the screen. But I get only three responses. Okay, Umesh. Umesh has sent me something. Okay, I will share.
Sir, Umesh only? Send no photo. I also.
Okay, you can see my screen. This is Umesh. Umesh, this is Umesh and Hajira. Umesh?
Yes, sir.
Oh, so cute, brother and sisters. Okay, then, okay. Shahid is here. Then once again, Alia. See Alia's grandpa's photos. Husna's. Okay, great. What about others? Please send me.
Sir, why this all photo you want?
No, I don't worry. I'm not going to do anything with the photo. This is just a lesson. I'm not going to take it. After this sending the photo, you can delete it. Okay.
So, I have like memory of our past, like history.
Yeah. This is what history class means. It will be something interesting like that. That's the reason. Okay.
Well, I have written in chat box here.
Okay. Very good. Very good. So Sorry. I did not check the chat box. Sorry. A lot of you missed it. I will tell that I did. Okay. Okay, fine, great. Okay, I'm stop sharing this film. Now let me get back and ask you, why we're doing this? Why we were doing the exercise? I asked you something, some proof, right? So it's like a source. Your past, you're going, looking back at your past, what you were doing before. Well, you do not know what is the source, what I was doing. You can tell verbally, or somebody must have told you something. But that is not the proof for you. But in the case of sources, you are most of you will send me the photo. And this photo is a source that how you were in the past, how you were at the young age, how you were in your childhood. So you refer back to the sources of your past. Umesh, tell me.
Yes. Now, okay. Sir, that time... I remember that something. I was very angry to take pictures.
Okay. Oh, that day. Okay. Fine. See, it's also so nice, right?
Sir.
Yeah, tell me. Yeah.
Sir, I will send WhatsApp, sir.
Okay. Hussein also sir. Send. Hussein? Okay, I am a big. If I started to share this, we can keep on going. Only Hussein. Okay, Hussein, I will share yours. Wait, why to disappoint Hussein? Okay. Wow, Hussein, is it you? You, Shagid,
yes,
and
sir.
Asma?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yes, sir. So, nice.
I am my...
Sir, this is not clear. Can you zoom it?
You want to zoom it?
Yeah.
Can I zoom
it? Click it, that and zoom.
Now you can see Shahid is here.
Yes.
Oh, in that chair, Hussein was sitting.
Oh, so nice. Okay, great.
How they give pose.
So nice, family. This is I think this is Asma, and this is what is Shahid Pasha.
Shahid.
This is Hussein Pasha. This is his elder sister. What is her? What is her name? What is your elder sister name, Hussein?
Ali.
Amini, right, honey.
Honey.
Honey. Okay. Great. Thank you. Okay. Okay. All of you, all on mute. So we were seeing in this, what are the sources? When we wanted to look back to our past, we immediately get back to some sources to show some proof that how we were there, right? Like sources. The same thing we are doing in the case of history also. If you wanted to look back what you were doing in the past, what our nations were doing, what our world was doing, what the persons were doing, if you want to know everything, we need to get back to that. Okay? We need to get back to the sources so that we are able to say that this is true. What will happen if there is no source? If there is no source, it's not a history. Keep this in mind. If there is no source, it's just a story. Okay, there is a difference between story and a history. Story means the history will answer three questions. Where it happened, when it will happen, and for whom it will happen. The year, for example, I will give an example. Where means which place it happened. History will answer these three questions. Which place it happened, and when, which year. Maybe you were born in the year of which year? You all born maybe in the year 2000. You all 2000 kids, right? So 2000. Okay. Then whom, forward to whom? For example, in this case, we are talking about Arfad. So Arfad born, Arfad was born in, Arfad, tell me, complete the sentence.
94, sir.
Arfad, complete. Arfad. Arfad was born in
1994.
I am born in the year, this year, at this place. That is how. All your birth certificate is a record of where you born. So there are the sources. The same thing we are going to do with the sources of history. Yep. Give me a second. So it's a chapter one of your social science book. This is the part one. This has been divided different. History, you have political science, you have economics, you have geography. Okay, there are a lot of departments you have. The first part we will be dealing is history. So don't think social science mean it is not all about history. It's a wrong consumption. Social science mean it is history is there. Sociology is there, that you will be studying about the community, and you will also studying about the political science. Political science means it's about the administration that we already discussed in the last class. Yes, so sir. Administration. Then economics. Economics means it's all about the finance. How the economy of the country, what are the economic activities of our country, that we will be studying in economics. So a geography means that we will be studying the geographical structure of our nation, countries and the world. The map, everything is comes under geography. So there is a lot of things are there. So don't have a misconception about social science. Oh my God, social science means it's a history. It's really talking about the old people. It's all, they all dead and gone. Don't think like that. History is just one part of the social science. So you have a lot of fun in social science. So start to enjoy that. And in that, in your future, maybe those who like to continue after maybe 10th, if you wanted to continue in the humanities science, humanities department, there you have option to decide whether you want to, if you wanted to go for arts, you can use HEPS, it will come. History, economics, political science, sociology. But when you come to degree, again, you have three major paper. That will be again maybe any paper, but when you get into masters, you can specify in any subject. Maybe you can be a master of history, you can get a degree in master in sociology, you can get a master in degree in political science, you can degree in economics. Okay, there are a lot of things are there. So a lot of opportunities are there in social science. So don't get your mind just in the field of history alone. History just one part. That's what I wanted to say. Okay. Okay. I see two hands been raised. Please, you can tell your opinion fast, as fast as possible. Then we can proceed.
Sir, social science can increase our critical thinking, no, sir?
Definitely. Social science means all about the critical thinking. Because you are studying, I'm telling, no. Social science is studying, we are studying about the people, right? When we are studying about the people, people are a lot of people. People are different. Nations are different. Countries are different. States are different. All are different. So we are studying all the things and we are able to use and reflect and we are able to think critically. Yes, Umesh.
You know what doing? You're trying to make so we can like social science more and give interest.
What I am doing, yeah. Not like that. It's not like that. I know, because most of us have the wrong conception about social science. Okay, I just want to remove that stigma. That is the reason. Okay, it's not that I am.
Yes,
I want
sir.
See, I am an art student. I love social science, but at the same time, I love all the science subject as well. But I'm trying to remove the wrong conception we have about social science. It's a lovely subject. And we should not think social science means it's all about history. It's a lot of fields are there in social science. That's what. Okay, anyway, you're starting loving it. Umesh?
Yes, sir.
Okay, great.
Sir, he is absorbing your every action and telling.
Okay, fine. I love it. See, you can see when I speak about social science, there is some passion in me, right? Yeah, sir. Yeah, that's what you. I want you also should when you talk about your subject. It's my interest is this one. You maybe also have some interest in some other field. So show interest in that. So it's in my blood. So that's so don't feel bad when I speak about socials. Then I get excited. Great. So this objective of this class is today. There are three objectives. I'm not sure that we will be able to cover all the objectives. Maybe the first objective we will be able to cover it today. That is, we would be able to describe the importance of learning history. So what is the importance of learning a history? By learning the subject of history, what is the importance in learning? So that we will be able to do that first. Second one is, we would be able to describe and evaluate the literary sources of history. Now, what are the literary sources? In simple words, literary sources mean nothing. It is just what is written. Is it clear? All of you? So literary,
yes,
says, yeah, literary sources mean it's something written. So evaluate. So here what, as Aisha mentioned, we are able to critical thinking. Because, for example, I will tell example. I'm taking an example Bible, okay? I know that most of you, I don't know. You can also give an example in Quran if you have. Because I'm a Christian, I'm just giving an example. See, in Bible, we have a lot of chapters. The life of Jesus Christ been written by many people. We have the first four gospel, Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John. Four people have written about Jesus Christ. But you see, the four people's history is a little bit different. All are different. Now, which to rely upon? You understand my question? The same life story of Jesus. According to you, Jesus is, I think, Messiah. What do you consider? Messenger, right? Islam? I don't know. Okay, if you want, you can add that point. So the four people have different written about the same person differently. So the same way, the history mean evaluate the literary sources. So literary sources, the what is written, you are going to evaluate whether these sources, whether it is very real or it is not real. That you have to use your own analogy, your own reflection, your own critical thinking to come to a conclusion whether it is true or not. That's up to you. That I'm leaving to you. That's you have to use your critical thinking and find out. I won't tell. It's you have to do. The third one is we'll be able to describe and evaluate the archaeological source. Now, archaeological source means it is very simple. You must have seen some old buildings, right? Old palaces. For example, Mysore Palace is this one, and we have Bangalore Fort, we have a lot of Taj Mahal. This is all archaeological. Archaeological means it's all buildings. Clear? Buildings, coins, monuments, then everything will be there. Now you will evaluate this also. Whether these sources are real. So basically, literary sources and archaeological sources. This chapter is all about literary sources and archaeological sources. You are going to evaluate. And the first part today, we will cover the first objective that we would be able to describe the importance of learning history. Okay, if you all understood what we are doing it, can you please give me a thumbs up? What are we going to do in this class? If you understood Penny, can you please give me a thumbs up? Okay, Hussain, please, I want all of you to respond in the class. Hajira, I don't see Shahid responding. Umez is there with me. Alia, hello. Okay, Asma is with hello. Me. Hello, who is there? Hello. Nesika is with me. Mehra Q is with me. Arfad, what about you? You're not responding today.
Arfad is mood of don't disturb.
Oh, Arfad is mood of.
Yes, sir.
Okay, why you guys did some said something to him? Okay. Fine, no problem. I will catch up Arfad later. So thank you so much. Now, these are the three big... Okay, all of you on mute, please. So these are the three big questions you are going to ask. Ask me this question you will ask for yourself. Are all the resources are reliable? Reliable means, can I believe where this all the resources, maybe the archaeological sources or the literary sources, are these resources are really reliable? Can we trust them? Can we believe them? Because somebody said something about the nation, mean, is it true? That you are going to ask. For yourself, and which source is more reliable according to you? what you think is more reliable? Can I more rely on the literary sources or archaeological sources? Which people written? Who written that? Then why history needs resources? Now that is very important. Why history needs resources? That I already given introductory part. What is the difference between story and history? And now why history needs resources? Now let's get to the chapter of history. Give me a second. I need a volunteer to read. Who will read for me? We will listen to the people who are not yet heard. Nesika, can you read for me? Nesika? Nesika, are you there? Nesika?
Sir, can I read?
Nesika, I am asking Nesika to read. Let me... she's not responding. When I call her, she left the caller. Okay. Asfia, can you read? Asfia.
What, sir?
Read this. Come on, can
first
you read?
First one.
Yeah.
History is systematic study of the past.
Okay. Okay, thank you, Asfia. Anyway, I myself will read and I'll, because we have to finish it fast. If it is English class, I would have given you time that you will English class, but social science, we have to rush it fast. Okay, fine. So history, okay. See, these are the points. This is everything is from the text. If you want, I will send the PPT to you also. I will send, these are the notes for your exam also. Okay. You can take a screenshot or you can write down.
Or
I will send it. I will send the PPT to you.
Send the textbook.
Okay. I will send the PPT after the class. Okay. Yeah, done. So history is a systematic study of past. Okay. All be with me. Arfa, you want to say something? Your hand has been raised. Arfa?
I wanted to read that.
You want to read? Okay, read. Okay, Arfa to read. Okay, Arfa to read first four points. Then Aisha read. Aisha read the third point and Asma read the Arfa to read.
History is a systematic study of the past. History is writing on the basis of source. There is no source, no history. Historian is like an advocate.
Okay, thank you. After I explanation, Asma can read the second one. First, I'll give the explanation. See, history mean it's like we are going to the past. What happened in the past? History is not studying about the future. What will happen in the future? Okay. We are studying about what happened in the past, what is already got over. So that is why we say it's a systematic study. Okay. It's not something we study for the sake of studying. There is a way of studying history also. And the history is not simply they have written. History is not simply written. You cannot, if I told you, history needs resources. If you write a history without source, it becomes a story. But in the case of history, it is written on the basis of resources. There are two sources we have, I already told, literary sources and archaeological sources. Please keep a note of that. Two sources, literary sources and archaeological sources. Literary mean written. Archaeological mean based on the buildings or the coins, everything will come in there. That I will explain the later. So two sources based on that. And I told you, if there is no source, no history. If there is a source only, it's a history. If there is no source, it becomes a story, just a story. And now why I say historian? Yeah. Okay, I'll finish then. Historian is like an advocate. No. Listen, as I was saying, I'll finish this part. Why I'm saying historian is like an advocate? What is the role of advocate? Advocate is a role in a court and role. You must have watched many movies. You must have seen how the advocates, they argue for their case. They need the proof, right? They need to give some proof that this person is committed this crime. So I am giving this proof. If you don't have a proof, that person cannot be punished. The same way, history also needs a source. You cannot write a history without giving any proof. In a case of proof, mean sources. So historian, historian mean, now you see historian mean the person who writes the history. Is it clear? Historian mean a person. This is a historian mean. It's a person who writes the history. There are many historians we have. We will study that. So historian means, now you know who is the father of history? Anybody?
Yes,
who is the father of history?
From start from A. Let me read.
Anybody? I asked, nobody answered. Who is the father of history?
Aristotle.
Yeah, Aristotle.
Aristotle, no. Aristotle is the father of political science.
Aristotle is the father of history.
Aristotle, no. The father of history is, father of history is Herodotus.
Yes, sir.
Herodotus. Okay. Father of history is Herodotus. All, please keep that mind. Father of political science is Aristotle. Father of economics is...
Sir, Aristotle is father of...
I will tell. There is a social science means what are four things. I will just a clue I will give. Father of sociology is Auguste Comte. Father of history is Herodotus. Father of economics is Adam Smith. And father of political science is Aristotle. So these are basic four branches. So please, history means Herodotus, okay? Okay. Next, Asma, read the next point. Asma has raised her hand first, Hussain. I'll give you a chance, Hussain. Okay, Asma, read fast.
Historians collect the source subject them to critical examination, analyze, and then write the history.
Okay. So historians, basically how they write, they have, first the duty of the historian is they have to collect all the resources. Whatever resources available, they will collect those resources. So whatever resources are available, they will collect those resources. And based on that, they will use their own critical thinking. They will make them analysis about all the resources. And then they will write the history. They cannot simply go and write history based on something. They need some sources. And they will analyze all the sources. And then they will write the history. Okay, Aisha, last point.
Whenever data sources are not available, they need to make assumption based on the available sources. Hence, often an event is analyzed from different perspectives by different historians.
Okay, so I see in every case we don't the sources are not available. What will happen if the sources are not available? Okay, now can you hear me?
Yes, sir.
Okay, you can tell me, okay, if I'm talking very fast, you can tell me to, sir, can you please slow down? You can tell me always, give me your feedback is always welcome. So, am I going very fast?
There's options also, sir.
Okay, am I going very fast, you feel? Or then I'll reduce my speed.
No.
Okay, fine. So, when the sources are not available, what will happen? When I need to write, for example, I am a historian. I don't have any sources to write a history. So what will happen? I have only one or two resources, but I will make my own assumption. Oh, then this must have happened like this. Then this must have, because of this, this would have happened like, I will use my own analysis based on the little resources which I have. Is it clear? When all the resources are not available, whatever resources are available with me, with my own assumption. My own assumption means my own analysis, my own critical thinking I will use and I will write the history. That's how there are different perspectives come. That's why I gave an example of the Bible. There are four people have written about Jesus Christ, but the four people's history is different. Why? Because for them, not all the resources were not available to them. Only few resources were available to them. And based on their own assumptions, their own critical thinking, they have written. That's why the four resources are different. Okay, now I'll pause for a while. I see some hands been raised. Okay, Arfat first, Aisha second, Sahil Khan third. Come on. Arfat?
I forgot to lower my hand, sir.
Okay, Aisha?
Yes, sorry. Sir. Yes, my else.
Okay. Aisha, your hand is raised.
Yes, sir.
Your hand has been raised. That's why I'm just asking. Sorry, sir. Okay, fine. Now, who is putting music there? Now, what is the source? This is very, I already given a hint. What is the sources? If the things used by human beings in the past have remained, then they are called the sources by the historians. For example, olden days people, the people who lived before us, if something of what they used, if it is remained, that is considered as the sources. Hussain, don't do any drawing here. Hussain Pasha. Yeah. So the thing is, when, for example, we are living. Now we don't know how many years we live. Maybe after 100 years, we must have, we used a lot of things, right? And the people who come after 100 years, if they get something what we used, for example, now you are using your own mobile phone and your mobile phone become a source for the people who come after 100 years. Or the notebook you have written, that become a source for the people who comes after 100 years. Like that, if the things in human beings, what is used in the past, if you use that one, that become a source. Is it clear? If you're clear with the source, what is source, please give me a thumbs up. You understood what is source? I don't see any response. One of you, okay, only Mehak has understood. Asma, can you explain what is the source? Hajira, can you explain what is the source? Hajira. Alia, can you respond? What is the source? Alia. Alia is not responding. I'm noting down all the names. I'm going to give absent for everybody. Those are not responding. Alia. Okay, respond. Come on. Sir. Carry on. Now, Asma, go ahead.
If the source means our past, like what in history we get the past of, in history, we revise that.
See, the simple was what is used in the past.
Yes.
Okay, for example, 100 years before, maybe your grandfather, if you are studying about something what your grandfather used, maybe 50 years ago, if you are studying about that, that become a source. Okay, that is used in the past, not what that you are using in the present, that used by somebody else before you, that become a source. That's what source. So here, what are the sources? The past people, the people who came before us, they left for us agriculture tools. You must have studied in your earlier studies, you know, the tools they used, the ancient people, they used the stones too. Instead of knife,
yes,
they were using stones, and they were also having many tools to, for the for war metals. Everything has become a tools. And the forts, there are many forts are available. I'm sure that you are familiar to the fort in Bangalore. Bangalore, we have a fort. You know that? How many of you visited Bangalore fort? Okay. Now, one thing I'm interesting thing I'm saying, if the corona would not have been there, I would have definitely taken you all for historical places visit. We can go to the one day we'll plan out. Okay.
I go to Red Fort.
Okay, we will. Okay, very good. We'll plan out. Okay, we'll, if you all are cooperating with me, if you all are responding in the class nicely, I will definitely take you to the some historical places in Bangalore. Bangalore, we have many places. We will one day we'll have a visit to that places. Okay, now the fort. Fort being a Bangalore, we have a fort in KR Market. KR Market is very next to you, right? There we have Bangalore fort. It's been built by Tipu Sultan. So like that, forts mean where the kings, they used to stay. That is kings and their war used to happen. They are being protected. That is a fort. Then coins. We also study about history. We study about the history with the help of coins. Then inscriptions. Then arms. Arms mean the thing, metals we use for a war, everything to fight. What are the things we use for while fighting? Then temples. Temples also become a sources. Religious building. We have also, you have mosque, many mosques we have, right? That also become a source. And the religious building, whether the Hindu temples or the Christian buildings or Islam buildings or any other Buddhist temples or Jain temples, all become a source for everybody. And similarly, written documents, I told. whatever is written about something, that also become a source. And the materials. There are a lot of materials being used by the writing of the history. So that also consider. These are all the sources, main sources. Please keep as the background. Then let's go to the next. This is what the main slide. This is what sources. Please take a screenshot of this and keep it. You will make a connection. You will be able to understand it very easily. Have you taken screenshot, everybody? You can share it in the group as well. It's actually this I have taken from your. This is actually a picture from a sixth standard.
Yes, sir.
It will give a summary of what is a source. What is the sources of history? In simple words, I'll explain what are those. I will use my annotation marker. Give me a spotlight. Yes, here it is mine. So the sources of history, we have two types: literary sources, archaeological sources. As I told in the beginning, literary sources mean, we will see what is literary sources, what is archaeological. Literary sources are divided into two. That is written literature and oral literature. Written literature means what is written. When you 100 years before, somebody has written about something, that become a written literature. Oral literature means it has been, for example, Quran is become a written literature, right? Through Quran become a written literature, Bhagavad Gita is a written literature, and a lot of things are there. And a Bible also. Then oral literature means it passed on to people to people. For example, your grandpa must have passed on to your father, and your father must have told something to you. So it is from one person to one person. From your grandfather to your father, and your father to you. So it is from one people to one people. It's become oral. It is oral mean? Oral mean verbally. Through your mouth. Okay. This is what called oral literature. This is written. That's a difference. You should know the difference between written and oral. Now, the written literature itself has been divided into two. There are native literature and foreign literature. Native literature means our own country. For example, native literature means it's India. If the history of India is written by Indians, that become a native literature. And we have a native literature like, what are the native literature we have? Mahabharata. What are the other things? Ramayana. Then a lot of things are there. Written native literature means the literature written by the local people. Local people mean what, Hajira? Who is making noise here now, right now? Don't disturb me. I told you, if you wanted to talk, once I finish explaining this, I will give time for you to ask question. But don't disturb now. Hajira, please keep yourself mute. Okay, thank you. So native literature means, once again I'm explaining, it is written by the local people. Native means, for example, if it is written by Indians, that become a native literature. Indians written by India is become a native literature. For example, if the history of India is written by the foreigners, British people, that become a foreign literature. Is it clear? The native literature means what is written by our own people, it's become a native literature. And if somebody has written about, some foreign people have written about us, that means that makes a foreign literature. Then coming to the oral literature, we have through things like Levinas, folk tales, history, legendary. Levinas means it is also, it's been said by the people. It's been communications through, it's a kind of art. It's like, what is that? They use, it's kind of a poem or something. They used to praise the people. Okay. Maybe they used to praise their kings and everything. So that is Levinas. And folk tales mean the stories, the small tales they have, folk tales they have, the cultures. So this is the one. See, Levinas, you give the example here. This is the picture. The people who used to praise for king and all, everybody, they will just make this noise. And folk tales been usually said by the stories by our grandparents. And the historic legendary. Legendary mean the legends. All the places have legends. For example, Gangodhanahalli. Gangodhanahalli is the name of the place. And what is the, there is a legend. What is the name behind the Gangodhanahalli? That has become a legend. Then coming to the archaeological sources, we have monuments. Monuments means it is nothing. It's all buildings. Monuments mean it's nothing. It is just buildings. Coins. We study history based on the coins. And we have also coins to study the history. Inscription mean was you must have noticed many temples or they must have written something on the stone. If something is written on the stone, yes. It is called inscription. That is inscription. And other archaeological resources also cover the remains. For example, you must have seen all the temples has been destroyed temples, right? Destroyed temples, destroyed mosque. That become an other archaeological resources. That also tells something about the history. So these are the archaeological resources and these are the literary resources. Now let me pause for a while. I have spoken more. Now it's time for you to ask your question. Come on. Any doubt, any clarification? Let's finish it right away. Then let's proceed. Any doubt on this? The sources of history? Please raise your hand. Nobody has any doubt? All clear with that?
No, sir, we don't have doubt.
No doubt.
Sir, yeah. We have done this in 6th class. This was done.
When you are done?
In 6th, yes, came this in 6th.
Yeah, it is the same 6th standard. 6th standard also the same. They have sources and 8th standard also the sources. 6th standard, yeah, it's they will study a little bit. These are actually this picture I have taken from the 6th standard book only because it will give a what is a clear picture of what it meant to be. That's the reason I took this picture.
Yeah,
in your textbook, you don't find this kind of picture. In your book, it is just written. Everything is written in words. So I wanted to make it very simple. I wanted to make it very simple for your understanding. That's why I have taken this pick.
Sir, what about your stone social study club?
Yeah, that we will discuss. I have not. You have any doubt with this? If you have not any doubt with this, shall I go ahead with the next?
Yeah, sure.
You can create a group. Social science club. Those who are interested in social science, we will do something. We will discuss every day and we will plan out something.
We can do lots.
Okay. Okay, let's continue with the next. I already explained. This is something for you. I'll not explain it later. So read by yourself, one by Hussain Pasha, read. You were asking for many time, no? You were for a long time. Hussain Pasha, read. I know that Hussain does not know to read. Okay. Aisha has read. Asfia read. Nesika, you are not responding. Why you are not responding?
Written. Written.
Okay. No problem.
End of London is the main. Man,
Hussain, no problem. It will take, we will read later. We will read later. I will help you to read.
Sir, can I?
Who is that? Aisha read. I'll give the chance to the people who are not yet read.
Sir, okay. I want to read once more.
Okay, Aisha once more. Afterwards, Aisha Asma. Okay, Aisha read.
Written
literature
it can bring the contemporary social life of the times of the writer alive to us. A literary work portrays the then existing or as aspects of life, either directly or indirectly. There are two types in written literary forms. a native
foreign literature. Okay, so what is about literature? Written literature is a main source. Why we say Asma and Shahid allow the people to enter in? Or okay, who are true? Okay, so why we say written literature is a main source?
Your voice is stuck.
Hello, can you hear me now? Arfa,
voice is stuck.
Is it stuck?
No, sorry,
it's clear. Is it clear? Maybe, man, Arfad, you may be having internet issue, I think. Okay. So, written literature is the main. So, in all the things, which is the main source is written literature. Written literature means? Is our class supposed to end at 12:15, right? 11:15?
Yes.
Okay, then fine. I am ending with the today's class. Thank you. So one of you, I need one volunteer. Okay, Aisha, you remind me, yes, social science class after just 5 minutes before that, before ending the class. Okay, maybe the class ends at 11:15. Give me a reminder at 11:10. Okay. So always social science class. You give me a reminder, okay? Aisha will be giving. Why? No, others don't feel bad. Why I am giving Aisha social science? Because Aisha is showing so much interest. Maybe others, if you also showing so much interest, I will give chance for everybody to give me a reminder. Okay. Maybe one day Arfad can do. Okay.
Asma also
can do. Husna also can do. Anybody can do. Okay, no problem.
I have seen Asma showing there interest on social science. This is the first time I am seeing.
Oh, Asma is showing so much interest in social science.
Yeah.
You know, sir.
Yeah, tell me.
Can you leave now? Your class is ended.
No, sir. Oh, one minute. I need to take your attendance. Please, let me take a. I will take a screenshot. Wait a minute. I will take a photo and I have to take attendance, right? Give me all of me be there. Only these 13, 12 people are going to get attendance.
Sir, level 15, no.
You are coming. Yeah.
Your class ends.
Stop recording.
Yeah, fine.